That says 2.5 horsepower, but that says 2.5 horsepower. Does that mean size really doesn't matter? Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. Sorry that I used profanity in my click image. Sadly, this video is going to have another four-letter word that a lot of people really dislike. Math. The reality of electric motors is typically size does matter. There are a lot of factors that go into the torque and horsepower of a motor, but the two key ones are the size of the coil and the size of the magnet. Typically speaking, the bigger the coil, the bigger the magnet, the more torque you're going to have, which is going to result in more horsepower. Horsepower is a term that we're all familiar with. You see people all the time going up to someone who owns a hot rod or classic car and going, "How much horsepower does that thing have?" Thing is, horsepower is not the important number, especially when dealing with DC motors. The important number is torque. Looking at these tags, nowhere is torque mentioned. Horsepower, yes. Torque, no. Max RPMs, mentioned. Torque, no. If only there was a way to use horsepower numbers and RPMs to determine torque. So the formula for horsepower is torque times RPM divided by 5252. Now, why would we want a number that is calculated to determine how powerful something is? The main reason is inertia and kinetic energy. In the case of a vehicle, you have spinning parts that have kinetic energy built up. You have the speed of the vehicle. So in those cases, horsepower, especially at the top end, can really make a difference. On an electric motor, it's all about torque. Torque is the amount of force that the motor is applying. The nice thing about a DC motor is the torque curve is flat. In other words, if it produces 1 pound-foot at 100 RPMs, it's going to produce 1 pound-foot at 1,000 RPMs. Now, if you're attaching that to something that has a spinning mass, like you're hooking it up to a lathe that has a fairly heavy chuck, or you're using a flywheel on the motor, horsepower will have some effect in overall function because the higher the RPMs, the more kinetic energy you're going to store in that mass. So in that case, horsepower sort of has value, but for the most part, all horsepower does is gives us a way to calculate torque. Sadly, everyone knows the term horsepower, and so that's the number they go with. Manufacturers use that to their advantage. They may have a motor that runs higher RPMs and doesn't have a whole lot of torque, so they can use that calculation to label it as a higher horsepower, which technically it has, or in this case, two motors with the exact same horsepower. But this motor right here is going to significantly outperform this motor because this one has way more torque. So if we know that horsepower is a calculation of torque and RPM, if we have horsepower and RPM, we can work backwards to get torque. If you take this number, 2.5, and you multiply it times 5252, and then divide by 6,700 RPMs, you get about 1.95 foot-pounds of torque. Conversely, on this one, if you take the 2.5 and you multiply it by 5,252 and divide by its RPMs, 3,200, you get 4.1 foot-pounds of torque. So that means that this is going to produce twice the torque that this one does. It's going to work way better, and depending on your application, you can go with a higher gear ratio because you won't be gearing it to try and increase torque. To make matters worse, yes, this says 2.5 horsepower, but right down here, it says 1.5 horsepower at continuous duty. So that means that 2.5 is not sustainable. So if we do the math for the continuous horsepower, 1.5, same calculation, we take that times 5252 and divide by max RPM, which is 6,700, we come up with 1.176. That means to make this motor function like this motor, you would have to gear this one at almost 3.5 to 1 if this one is geared at 1 to 1. In other words, every turn of this motor would result in a turn of whatever you're spinning. But 3.5 turns of this motor would result in 1 turn of whatever you're spinning. At that point, they would have comparable power. The important takeaway here is make sure you calculate your torque. Torque is the important piece. If you're replacing an AC motor with a DC motor, it will have max RPMs and it will have a horsepower rating. And yes, you can calculate torque based on that. But keep in mind the biggest difference between an AC motor and a DC motor is that AC torque increases as RPMs increase. Since we're dealing with max RPMs, the calculation you get with an AC motor is going to be max torque. It will be less than that at lower RPMs, but with a DC motor, torque is consistent through the entire curve. So next time you're looking at DC motors, make sure that you do the math. I know it's a four-letter word. Most of you don't like it. Do the math so that you know if your motor will be correctly sized for your application. I hope this helps.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.
Sorry that I used profanity in my thumbnail. Sorry that I used prevent.